Esta ciudad nunca fue tuya. Es mía.
Si no destruyo el colisionador, ninguno tendrá un hogar a donde regresar.
Recuerda que lo que te hace diferente...
¡Vámonos!
...es lo que te convierte en Spider-Man.
¿Oficial? Lo quiero.
Espera, ¿qué?
Ladies and gentlemen.
Miles Morales is Spider-Man. Miles Morales is Shameik Moore. Miles Morales is an example, the perfect example of the new phrase, anyone can wear the mask. Miles Morales is
Miles Morales is a Brooklyn teen. Morales is a Brooklyn teen. You know, he was you know, for people who aren't really comic book aficionados, Miles Morales was introduced into the Marvel sort of comic book universe in 2011. You know, I think he represents sort of a contemporary version of Peter Parker. He's, instead of being from Queens, he's from Brooklyn. You know, Miles also has a mother and a father and an uncle who are all very supportive of him. You know, and then so that's a different life experience. You know, he's multicultural, biracial. He's African American and Puerto Rican, he brings a different flavor to Spider-Man, and he lives in a universe where he lives in a universe where Spider-Man already exists, where Peter Parker's already there, and so when Miles is bitten by the spider, he knows what he has to try and be able to accomplish. You know, he's got this really high bar of a
I'm in shadow.
A practicing Spider-Man. Good question.
No spoilers.
I know, that's why I'm just going to like gauge this one. No, we see multiple villains in this movie. It's really fun to get the opportunity to kind of bring some villains that have been represented in comic books that maybe haven't been seen on the big screen before like this. You know, we have a really large version of Green Goblin that exists in Miles' origin story. We have the Prowler, who also exists in Miles' origin story. He's also my favorite, by the way. We have Tombstone, who's been around for a very long time, and we have Kingpin as our main villain. And we also might have a little guest appearance from Scorpion. And I think that's about as many as I can mention. In that it's a Marvel created universe.
Venom.
Yeah, I think there's room for these things to run parallel to each other, and if they end up someday sort of overlapping, maybe we'll all see.
Yeah, how did you guys choose what made the soundtrack?
In developing each character, we kind of gave each character a playlist, you know, that really we felt like if we were in their headphones, this is what they would be listening to. And so as you hear sort of the music evolve through the movie, there's a definite signature to each sort of character, but it's really all in support of what we thought felt like Miles' soundtrack.
Mm. Great soundtrack.
It is a great soundtrack, actually. There's a few songs that nobody's heard yet.
Innocent say I keep a check. She was a bad, bad, nevertheless. Calling it quits now, baby, I'm a wreck. Crash at my place, baby, you're a wreck. Ooh, certain things you just can't refuse. She wanna ride like a cruise, and I'm not trying to lose.
And you'll be left in the dust unless I stuck by. You're the sunflower. I think your love would be too much, or you'll be left in.